Hey there, and welcome to Real Investment News. I'm Mike O'Neill. Home builders are still confident about the market, but that confidence does seem to be slipping a bit. This morning, the National Association of Home Builders released its Housing Market Index. This is compiled from a survey of about 900 home builders that asked them to rate market conditions for new home sales now and in the next 6 months, along with prospective buyer traffic for new homes. Now, this morning, we saw that the number actually slipped a bit down to 70, and February's number was revised down to 71. That is the third drop in a row, but considering that December hit an 18-year high with a 74, the market is still strong, but we don't want this trend to continue, and there are a few issues out there that could be a problem. First, home prices. The Case-Shiller National Home Price Index shows that prices have been climbing steadily for years. In December, it actually hit an all-time high of 196.2. And take a look at mortgage rates. Since September, the average 30-year fixed rate mortgage has climbed from 3.78 up to 4.46%. That's a nearly 18% jump in just the past 6 months. Now, let's get away from indexes and percentages. Let's talk real money. Here in Houston, the median home price is about $315,000, but let's say we get a good deal and find a really, really nice home for about $300,000. Back in September, the monthly mortgage payment on that home would have been $1,394. That's not counting insurance or taxes. Now, that very same house right now would cost you $1,513 a month. In the end, you're paying more than $42,000 in interest alone. And Real Investment Advice, John Coumarianos, built this index showing home prices relative to the median income. This is nationwide. It starts here in 1987, goes forward. You would actually want to see this line staying closer to the middle there, but it doesn't. You would want it to stay flat, but it doesn't. The home prices actually took a dip in the 90s, and then after the year 2000, they soared. Ultimately, the relationship between median home price and a median income had increased by more than 50%. Then we had a crash and a recession. We never got back to even. We are still underwater. And with American consumer debt hitting all-time highs, personal savings hitting all-time lows, a lot of people cannot afford to pay extra for anything. Now, it should be noted that in the past, this index that we started with here, it does drop for a couple months at the beginning of the year before turning higher. But we have to be careful because with rising home prices and rising mortgage rates, well, that could put a damper on home buyers' enthusiasm. That's it for now. Thank you so very much for watching. Be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter, YouTube. Check out our past reports on realinvestmentadvice.com. I'm Mike O'Neill, and we'll see you again in a couple of hours.